tomorrow is today. So it's to artists to be able to prove that they are able to propose interesting creations.
So I hope it's with the interaction with the instrument, with the artifact, so the ghost in the machine.
Can you repeat, please, more?
So your hope on this matter is the interaction with the artifact, with the instrument.
I have big hopes. I have not, it's, you know, of course I have big hopes. It's not, absolutely not, not dark. But the thing is that you need to know how things are, they evolve, in fact. You need to know a lot about, and I was joking about sound banks, but we need this too. And the problem is that when you are using today, even if you are buying the complete 12 by 13 instruments where you have incredible sounds, that's absolutely great for very few euros, it's not really expensive. So it's how are you using this? And when we sometimes I'm giving prizes in festivals, for example, Annecy Festival, which is number one for animation, and I receive 40 scores for short movies in animation, which is very interesting because animation is really great for composers. And I'm really surprised to see that what I'm watching in animation is absolutely gorgeous, but the music is not at the same level. And it's a shame because I gave the prize some years ago and there were two scores, very interesting. One was not original, it was just orchestration, and the other one was absolutely great, and it was a shot, but they were working 1 year on this, and the result was absolutely amazing, so I gave them the prizes. But I think that the problem is that it's not to try to be like the guy I was listening to, and I want to do the same thing. I'm taking always the John Williams example, which is great, because of course John Williams is, but you see, it's when you are scoring animation, it's really the place where a composer can bring all his creativity. So, and it's very, very important to you, the creativity is not going easily. You have to work on this. You can be very creative, but if you are not working on this, you will listen to Spotify and Deezer, and you have every score in the world, you have absolutely everything. Sometimes I'm finding my music on Spotify, I didn't give my okay to this, but it's there. There is nothing better than being able of playing on stage to an audience, because you are sharing a very special moment, like we will do tomorrow. But it's very important of learning an instrument, because in today's age, this is a YouTube generation. It's very easy to, you know, if you want to play the John Coltrane solo on Giant Steps, it's very easy because you can. But before, 40 years ago, you had a vinyl, and you have to make, you know, to write okay, so you have all facilities. But it's very important, even if you are not a concertist, to be able to play an instrument. And of course, when you are a composer, the best instrument is the piano. I'm sorry to say that, because you know how the MIDI guitars are working. So, and the keyboard is piano. Today you have the blockbusters, okay, we have Ryan, not only Ryan, but okay. And you have Netflix, Amazon TV, right, soon Apple TV, So it's about theories. So, and there are some great theories, great composers. Breaking Bad music is gorgeous. And a lot of series are really fun. The problem is that you don't get any offers right with this. You are paid just to do this, and after it's finished with offers right. Concerning the festivals, etc., I think it's really, really important to meet people, and it's really important to think not only about cinema business, but also about music, just like doing songs, playing, if possible, if you can, live music, and not only scoring films. But the problem is, when you begin to be successful, it's hard to say no. It depends if you have children, if you want to see your children growing up or not, or you are just about your career.